那 everybody know the standard model, neutrinos strictly has no mass, and there's no left, right-handed neutrino, and but the various experiments already show us strong evidence neutrino has mass, even very small, and not only has mass, they also have mixing, and forever mixing, and so on. So how to explain that? Now one of the theories today is introducing sort of heavy neutrino, which has a majority nature, which means the heavy neutrino itself is its own antiparticle. So if there's this kind of majority nature of heavy neutrino, and we can get the lepton number conservation is not valid anymore, and can back maybe get the unit of two violation. So this will lead us to very interesting searching using this mechanism called Seagal mechanism. And the smallest of the neutrino mass is involved with a very heavy majority mass. And this mechanism explains why neutrino has mass as well as why they are so small. And in our theory, the cross-section can be divided in two parts. One is this part, they call very cross-section, which is more independent, only depends on the majority mass itself and the central energy. And another part is only dependent on the flavor of leptons. And before us, in the lab, they already have an experiment, L3 and Delph. They're searching for C decay, go to lepton and heavy neutrino. And they already set the limit, which is mixing parameter of electron and heavy neutrino up to about 90 GeV. Okay. And the 2011 and the 2012 data has different energy, one is 70 and the 80, and also has different luminosity, and in 2011 data only about 5 in the Fogova, and 2012 has about 12. I'm not going to detail about accelerator and detector and so on. The diagram we talk about is this mechanism, and based on the theoretical paper by Han Tao, and which is published in 2006 in the Physics Review letter. And this process has a very big advantage. Number one, has two same-sign leptons, which can largely suppress this QCD background. Another is this final staging has no missing ET. So it can suppress largely for the shooting background. So this is a very unique way giving us opportunity to search. And we already started in 2008 do a lot of Monte Carlo study because we only have data just a couple of years ago. And we produced this Monte Carlo events with Han Tao's key code in the material element calculation as well as from the RT, and that cross-section is very consistent with each other. And for the Monte Carlo, we try to understand what the signal looks like, and here is the electron and the jet ET and the eta distribution and so on. And we will see they are not really symmetric. And the leading jet and the leading electron PT distribution is quite different with the second reading. So in our analysis strategy, we make an asymmetric cut for both of them. I'm not going to detail about what the data set we are going to use. So this is simply, I will briefly talk about how we identify the electron. And CNS has very good detection of leptons, particular electrons. And we have very unique and very precisely high resolution electron colorimeter. And we first find the electron track in the E-cup, electron colorimeter. They have to be matched with the vertex and in the H card and so on. And the jet is we have very good coverage of hydrogen colorimeter as well. And the data we use double trick, double electron trick. And I'm not going to talk about detail about that because it's belong to the dileptron group, which is already designed how to trick the dileptron event. And the majority research is only small part of this effort. So we have only a small group of people, a couple of people doing that. And that's why we cannot ask a special trick for us, which only can use existing trick condition. And the primary vertex measurement play a very important role in our study, not only because we have to get a pile of collections, also because we have to estimate, distinguish real electron from the real event, from a majority nature event, or from secondary vertex, which is non-proton electrons. So vertex measurement in our analysis is particularly important. Also, we are in this study we're doing with the electron pair, but actually we also have to understand how muon looks like. So there's a muon selection as well, because muon also easily can be confused with the electron, and which we don't want to do that. For the electron selection, and first of all, we have a PT requirement, as I said before, we have to use the asymmetric cut in the 10 and 20. And also we have to get the vertex information and the requirement. And also has kind of a standard combination of black box, which has a lot of parameters inside. I'm not going to talk about the detail, which very experiment physics is involved. For the jet, and we have one is called loose cut, another is the high tight cut. And at the beginning we only use 20 GB cut as a loose cut because we want to keep as much as even possible. Only 5 was available by data, so we are not afforded to lose any. So we make very light cut. But finally, the purpose is that we want to beat the result from lab, which is only 90 GB. And eventually we found that the cut is too loose, and sensitivity is too low. So finally, we also made the 30 GB cut. And eventually, after we published the paper last year, and Atlas repeated our study. And exactly same strategy, exactly event selection and so on, but they rather the cut from 30 to 40, and actually they beat our result. We set a limit up to 200 GB, but they set to the 300 GB, of course with a little bit larger arrow. And this is, now let's talk about the paper. And in our analysis, as I said, the Bevel run, we have very good advantage. And separated Q-sheet and the 3D Bevel run, but nevertheless, we still have three types of important Bevel run. One is from standard mode, and a lot of diagonal production, which produce a lot of leptons. And some of them can survive by our very serious cut. And the real electron probably were lost from the signal, but from dipole And then eventually we get the same sign electron, which is one of them is not a real signal. So all the same go to the geometry gap and so on. So this thing is a Monte Carlo, but we suppose this should be very small. Another is from the measurement of the electron charge. And there's an important background, which is from charge mismeasurement. And this case for the muon channel is very less important because the muon charge measurement very well because they have a very long track and it's very mischarge for the muon is only less than 0.01%. For the electron, it's quite a lot, so we have to deal with that. The last one, which is the most important one, is the so-called fake electron. And there's two major sources can fake electron, one from jet. And those jet can be misidentified as a jet, as an electron, and as well as some properly, non-properly electron, like from B decay and so on, also can be misidentified as an electron. So those are the most important background we will see about that. So for standard model, background is easy to deal with. We generate using Monte Carlo generator, generate a lot of Monte Carlo events with different things and many linear type. Actually, at the beginning, we always consider W or WC or TT by the important, but the people still think maybe more and so on. So we add a list there, and eventually we found a very small contribution. Is the total Monte Carlo background compared with one is less than about 5%. For the charge misid background, and what we dealing with is using so-called half data-driven method. We first generate some electron and in Monte Carlo, and find compare with the generator level of charge and then the contract level of the charge. And then to see how much different it is. This is the Monte Carlo mischarge rate. And then this is the Monte Carlo. Then we use data and try to get the Z control region, which is using the dielectron mass in the Z mass region and so on, and non-missivity. Then create a data set which is the Z control sample. And then apply the mischarge misid go to Z, control the data sample, and we get the opposite sign, Z, and the lepton pair, electron pairs, and the same sign. And the principle, if you don't have any mischarge ID, then you should always get the opposite sign, but it actually is not. This is our trouble of errors from the measurement. And then apply the previous plot from Monte Carlo, charge misid, go to the opposite sign of the control sample, and get another number compared with the measurement number. This will, if they should be very close to each other, and which means our method is correct, the error or difference between real measurement and apply the charge misid, it can be all systematic error. So this is what the algorithm about it. This is what we got. And the charge misid as a function of the electron PT and the eta. And finally, what we got is, for example, in our Z control region, we get about 2145K opposite sign event, among which also has about 109 same sign event. This they apply this miss ID rate to that, get 120. So 120 and 109 very close to each other. Then the difference is about 25%. So this is our systematic error for the charge miss ID. So most important background is, as I said, is a fake electron background. This algorithm is a little bit complicated. This is developed by CMS special group from the dielectron analysis group. The idea is, what is the real electron? So they define a so-called analysis object, which electron has to pass very serious old selection procedure. So in another object, most of them are new electron. Then we try to remove some of the requirement. And the one important rule requirement is isolation from point 1 to point 6. So in this case, allow some jet to be passed. So allow some jet to become an electron. Then another thing is the rules, some vertexing requirement. Then allow some secondary non-proton leptons become proton leptons. So after rule that, and then we create the fake rate, which means a possibility, which can pass FO, but from FO also can pass AO. And from this rate, then we apply to the data and recalculate with the complex weighting formula and then calculate the real how much it could be. And this is the table we got, which is the fake rate is a function of eta and pt for different run, which is quite stable, you can see that. And then finally we got the result, fake rate, then come what is the validation we use Monte Carlo, generate the TT bar and the WG and the QCD and so on, and then compare to verify or estimate for the fake background is correct. So what this is a little bit technical detail in the experiment. For FO definition, I set the rules from point 1 of point 6 to point 1 and so on. But how? If we change a lot, then it means very artificial. So very biased. So we check when if we're loading from point 6 to point 4, 5, or point 9 and so on, is the result almost stable and the one final out is quite stable. So this means it's not very biased. Then the technique to reconstruct the Majorana mass is another story. Because in this diagram you can see, and these two leptons in the from experimental point of view, they are identical. And there's no way to distinguish them. And only when this one we then call dot electron. And this one we call theta electron. Which is, if we want to reconstruct the Majorana, and we have to use two jet, reconstruct the W. Then using the W, and then together with the dot leptons to reconstruct A. So which one you should pick? And this, if you look at the selection paper, they consider it a very, very serious problem for the combinatory background. And we found, after very much testing, we found if we take the small leading electron, the more likely it's a dot electron. But only for 50 GeV Majorana, then we get about 73% right, or 90%. But if the Majorana mass get a lot, they're close to 50, which means nothing. So, combinatory background is still very important for our study. But we did not reach this point yet because we don't have enough data to reconstruct the mass. We just so far still algorithm study. At the beginning, when we start to study this search in 2008, we planning we were expecting we get 14 TV, 10 to the 33, but eventually we only get 7 TV and 10 to the 32. So not enough data anyway. And this is our final result, which is Monte Carlo. Sedana model is only about 30, and the mischarge is about 10, and the mischarge is about 30. And the observed is about 200, and the fake background about 170. So it is not exceeded from observation and experimental data and the background information. See, we have type, it means the PT of jet using 30 GeV. And this we try to reconstruct the mass. And the point is the data. and the different color indicate the different background. So there's not any indication has a signal there. So what we got is for missing ET greater than 50 GeV, which means it's not contributing, not signaling. And then in the missing ET, if less than 50 GeV, it means our signal reading. And for the control reading, we compare with a different cut, and their background information is consistent, which means our analysis is not really biased. And for the signal reading, which missing ET less than 50 GeV, and we got the result and try to set up the limit. This is what we got. So this two curve is from left result, which already showed in my previous in the which is the truck the curve here. And then mixing element is here, and we sensitivity up to here is about 200 GeV. So we beat the left result by about 100. So this is our result. That's it.
Of them. So this needs
and I have to produce a lot of Monte Carlo events. And with the special for us, then sometimes CMS production team does not want to do that. This another, we already started for that.
Because you need very, each new victory must have been studied already, so you cannot use that directly from other studies?
No. The signal they have to produce it by ourselves. Yeah.
Okay, I've taken enough time. Any further questions from the audience? If not, I have another question.
Okay.
So I didn't understand how you say this leads to an estimate of 25% systematic observer.
Okay. So this is observation. It's about in the Z control region we get a 15,000 events of this time. And then at the same time, we also get a global 9 same time, which should not be. If it's a pure Z, and it should not. But then apply the discharge rate from Monte Carlo electron gun, apply to that, and then produce same sign, it's about 120. This is 109 is a measurement. 120 is a prediction from the Monte Carlo. The difference between 109 and 120 is about 25%.
Okay, so